You know what happens when the police arrest white supremacist, white racist? Well, white racist people threaten to kill them. That's what happens. Now, do you really think that white nationalists are pro-police and somehow Black Lives Matter is anti-police? Let me provide a contrast here. White nationalists who decided to commit to a criminal act or attempt a criminal act get arrested. They get arrested, they go to jail. White nationalists throughout the country, they now threaten to kill the police chief and other cops. Let's contrast that. How many Black Lives Matter protests ended in arrest? Many. People got arrested. How many members of Black Lives Matter, or those who are with the movement, called the police department and threatened to kill the police chief or kill other cops? That's interesting, isn't it? Okay, the Idaho police that arrested 31 members of the white nationalist group Patriot Front, they are now under threat. They've been receiving death threats since the arrest, all right? They arrested them because this group was going to create havoc and violence at an LGBTQ plus event over the weekend. Let's go to the video.
I will tell you that I had one of our captains assigned to listening to all the phone calls this morning, and of the 149 calls that we know of so far that have come in, they're about 50-50 split between individuals in our community who are happy to give us their name and tell us that they're proud of the work that we did, and they're happy to be a part of this community. And the other 50% who are completely anonymous and who want nothing more than to scream and yell at us use some really choice words, offer death threats against myself and other members of the police department merely for doing our jobs. Those people obviously remain anonymous and don't tell us where they're from, although we had a call as far away as Norway.
Cowards. White nationalist, the movement significantly connected to the conservative movement rooted in violence. It is rooted in violence. That's why you see this kind of response. Officers also have received threats of doxing, phone numbers or addresses online. White said the majority of the threats being made appear to be from outside of the Coeur d'Alene community, according to the chief. The 911 caller who reported the little army of white nationalists will not be identified, White said in a quote. Since myself and other members of my agency have been receiving threats, including death threats, I think it appropriate to withhold that person's information. And I actually agree with you. Additionally, police had received prior threats from opposing groups leading up to the city's annual Pride in the Park event, which highlights the civil rights struggles of the LGBTQ communities. Additional staff were allocated to the Pride event, but there was no intelligence specific to the group Patriot Front, White said. White praised the 911 caller for their diligence in reporting what they saw, saying it likely prevented a dangerous conflict. Once again, another police chief doing it the right way. Doing it the right way, applying the law fairly. Equal application of the law. Now, there are many jurisdictions who actually stopped lawful gay pride or LGBTQ plus pride events, stopped them. We heard no report from the police chief or other cops that members of that community or those that supported them decided to threaten to kill the police chief. It's not the spirit of the movement. You have to understand you're dealing with different spirits, different dynamics, different sentiments here. Black Lives Matter, the LGBTQ plus community, these groups are about freedom and liberation, coalition building, love, unity. Groups like Patriot Front are antithetical to that position. When the law is applied accurately, they get offended. They don't complain, they then threaten violence because that's the core of their actual movement. AB, thoughts on this?
Definitely. So I think it's ironic that these groups were upset about defunding the police, but then when you don't get your way, it's okay to be extreme and threaten to kill them, right? Thank you to this police chief for doing the right thing and for protecting this group. The reality is that these patriots, right, they came with grenades, right, gas grenades. You came to do harm. You were arrested because you did something criminal. That is why you went to jail. So there's no point in sending them death threats. They did their job, and that community should be happy that the police were on top of it and able to do their job. At the end of the day, period. That's all that matters. I think it's also ironic that this group feels like, you know, they don't appreciate the pride event because they're grooming children. But when you come to inflict violence on people who are just enjoying their liberties, the liberties that white men have never had to fight for, have never had to march for, what type of example are you showing children at that point? What type of grooming are you doing then? You're grooming people for hatred. You're grooming people for violence. And more of you will be arrested. So let's be wise about the decisions that we make. If you don't like what they're doing, stay away from it. But you don't understand how it is to have to fight for your rights, fight for your liberty just to be yourself.